Luckily, the deli on the corner started towering with sour cream. I brought it back to great-grandpa Julius. Now you're talking, he said when he saw it. He gobbled it up. Not bad, not bad at all. But tomorrow, Zach, be sure your deli man doesn't skimp on the sour cream. Boy, this cat was pushy. Listen, I can buy you herring and sour cream every day, Ike said. I only get $30 a week allowance, and I won't be able to buy it fully over Thanksgiving weekend. I won't even be here. I'm going to Chicago to visit Grandma Lee. We're going to visit Lee? He asked daintily. I am, I said. You're staying here with a neighbor. You'd go to Chicago and you wouldn't take me to see my own daughter? If Lee heard Iron Rains or Nate and didn't come to see her, she'd be crushed. Well, I said, let me ask my dad. Dad, said my dad, I'm willing to go along with a joke, but we both know cats can't talk. Although, I must admit I'm tempted to bring him to Chicago, just to see the expression on Grandma Lee's face when you tell her that cat is her father. Dad, I really like to take him to Chicago. I think it'll mean a lot to him. I tell you what, said my dad. If you can get him to talk to me, you can take him to Chicago. I went back to my room, where great-grandpa Julius was pawing through my collection of baseball cards. You have any cards with low teacup of Roger's Hornsby on them? He asked. No, I'm afraid not. Gathering and Hornsby were nice fellas. Gob not so nice. That's what I hear. But after he signed my baseball, you say you actually met Low Gearing my teacup Roger Hornsby. I said, the Tomcat nodded. What happened to the ball they signed? I have it. Where? In a safe place. Don't worry about it. So, did your father say I could come to Chicago? He said, on one condition. What's that? You have to talk to him. I don't think he believes you can talk. That's all I have to do? Talk to him? That's all. Okay, let's do it. I followed great-grandpa Julius, who padded into the living room, where my dad was reading the newspaper. Dad, I said, great-grandpa Julius has something to say to you. Really? Said my dad. He put down his paper and turned toward the cat, with a big smile on his face. All right, he said, tell me, what was the hardest part about changing from a person into a cat? Where Grandpa Julius looked at my dad a moment without speaking. Then he cocked his head, opened his mouth, and said, for me, I guess the hardest part was finding out there was no door. You could look behind you in the litter box. Is that good enough for a trip to Chicago? My dad's eyes looked like they were going to pop right out of his head. Sounds good enough to me, I said. How about you, Dad? Chapter 5. What my dad found on my cat was great-grandpa Julius. He kept asking him questions about what it was like being dad. They never let up for the 2 days before we left off for Chicago. And ordering the long ride to the airport, some people who died and were brought back to life again claim they went through what looked like a very long tunnel with very bright lights at the other end. That's my dad. And all their dad relatives met them on the other side. Did that happen to you? I remember going through a long tunnel and coming out to bright light on the other side, said Grandpa, Great-Grandpa Julius. You do? Said my dad actually. Yes, said Great-Grandpa Julius. It happened to be the Midtown Tunnel, and the bright light on the other side was Queens. That's where they buried me. Tell me something. Would you happen to have a cigar on you? It's been years since I've smoked a really good cigar. You should stop smoking cigar, I said. They're bad for you. I guess you're right, said Great-Grandpa Julius. But something you just don't stop prepping, even after you're dead. How long have you been a cat? Asked my dad. I don't have a driver license on me, said Great-Grandpa Julius. How old do I look? About 12 or 13, I said. That feels all about right, he said. Of course, I didn't come back as a cat right away. You didn't? Oh no, first I was caterpillar. A caterpillar? I said. What was that like? Extremely boring. Mostly it was about eating leaves. I had leaves and tried to pretend they were herring with sour cream. Say you wouldn't by any chance happen to have a little scraps on you? What scraps? I asked. Liquor, said my dad. No, I'm sorry, I don't carry on me. We arrived at the airport, that paid the cab driver. I tried to put Great-Grandpa Julius back into his cab carrier. Hey, Seymour, he cried. Don't make me travel in a suitcase again. I'm a disgusted old geezer. For pity's sake, in a past life, you were a dignified old geezer, I said. In this life, you're a stray cat, and cats travel and cat carriers. Julius sighed and got into his carrier. Once we got on the plane, Dad started in again with his question. So, Julius, said Dad, after you were a caterpillar, did you become a butterfly? No, almost, said the voice inside the cat carrier. Mostly, that was about eating sweaters. You ate sweaters? I said, ugh! Don't nuk it till you try it, said Great-Grandpa Julius. I remember one fine cashmere turtleneck. It was almost as tasty as a corned beef on rye. Then one night, I happened to fly a little too close to a church outside a Polynesian restaurant and another tunnel. No, no, Miss, don't get tunnel. Only humans get tunnel. After that, I became a mouse. And that was all about eating cheese, I suppose, said my dad. No, about eating wood, don't ask. Wait a minute, I said. First, you're a caterpillar. Then you're a mouse. Then a mouse. How did you have time to be all those things? We're not talking about a lot of time here, said Great-Grandpa Julius. You could die, you stretch as a caterpillar, then a mouse, and you could still be back by a week from Thursday. But time didn't matter to me, I was dead. I had quite a lot of leisure time on my hands. Excuse me, said the flight attendant, as she passed our row. In preparation for takeoff, please make sure you sit fast and scarcely fasten and that your seat backs and tray tables are in the upright and locked position. Hey, Cookie, said Great-Grandpa Julius. What are you doing after the flight? The flight attendant did my dad said that. Because she gave him a dirty look. Then we buckled up. Next up, Chicago. Before we see her, I just want to ask you one thing, said my dad in the elevator of the building on Lake Shore Drive where Grandma Lee lives. What's that? I asked. Grandma Lee is in her 80s. Do you really think it's safe to tell a woman in her 8 had her dead father? It's no cat. Grandma Lee is very peppy. Open mind person, I repeated. I'm sure she'll take the news okay. The elevator doors opened on the 7th floor, and we walked down the hall to Grandma Lee's apartment. My dad carrying our lunch, and my carrying the carrier with Great-Grandpa Julius in it. Grandma Lee was so happy to see us. She kept hugging and kissing us all over the place. When we were all settled in her apartment, she noticed the cat carrier for the first time. Don't tell me you brought an animal all the way to Chicago, she said. Not just any animal, Grandma, I said. A very special animal. Special in what way? Asked Grandma Lee. Special in the way that he is not only a cat. He is also a member of our family, I said. In other words, you love him so much. You feel he's a member of our family, as Grandma Lee. I looked at my dad and then back at Grandma Lee. No, I said, I mean he really is a member of our family. And with that, I opened up the cat carrier. Grandma Lee and Great-Grandpa Julius took their first look at each other. Grandma Lee, I said, I believe this is your father, Great-Grandpa Julius. Grandma Lee stared at the cat in silence for a moment and then shook her head. No, she said, I don't believe at this. My father was taller. Lee, dear, said Great-Grandpa Julius, it's wonderful to see you again. How have you been all these years, my darling? It's talking to me, said Grandma Lee in a very strange voice. A cat is talking to me in the English language. He is, I said. Lee, dear, said Great-Grandpa Julius. I may be a cat, but I'm also your father. It's still talking to me, said Grandma Lee. Am I right about this, that the cat is still talking to me? You're right, I said. Tell the cat I said it's not your father, she said. Why don't you tell him yourself? I suggest. I don't talk to cats, said Grandma Lee in the same strange voice. Grandma Lee says, you're not her father, I said. I heard her, said Great-Grandpa Julius. What am I, dear? Then the cat softened his voice. Lee, dear, don't you remember me? It's Daddy. Tell the cat I said that we never called my father by the name of Daddy, said Grandma Lee. Ask it what we call my real father. She says, what name did she call you? I asked. I heard her. Great-Grandpa Julius' voice was rising. You don't have to repeat everything, she says. Well then, what name did she call you? I wasn't Daddy, said Great-Grandpa Julius. We barely heard her say it wasn't Daddy, said my daddy. Of course it wasn't Daddy, said Great-Grandpa Julius. Because it was father. Grandma Lee shook her head. Tell the cat it wasn't father, said Grandma Lee. She says it was. Don't repeat it, I snapped Great-Grandpa Julius angrily. Then he quickly recovered his composure. It wasn't father. Of course it wasn't father, he said. Father was what I called myself. What you called me was Papa. Tell the cat it wasn't Papa, said Grandma Lee. Oh, boy, said great-great-grandpa Julius. Could I ever use a gray cigar or a glass? Oh, snap, right about now. Lee, dear, I'm over 100 years old. I've been a caterpillar, a moth, a mouse. I've died many times, so my memory isn't quite what it used to be. Could you please give me a break here and tell me what you used to call me? Go on, Grandma Lee, I said. Tell him what you used to call him. I didn't call the cat anything, she said. I called my father my real father, my human father, Poppy. Poppy, Stompy, said great-grandpa Julius. He waved his paw dismissively. How far is Poppy from Papa? Wait a minute, said Grandma Lee. I just realized something. What's that? I said. Did the cat say it wanted a good cider or a grass glass of snap? That's what he said, I said. My father Julius never smoked cigars, and he never drank snapper. You know who smoked cider and drank snap? Who? I said. Who? Said my dad. The black sheep of the family. That's who. Your cat is a liar, Zach. He's not my father, Julius, at all. He's your grandpa's no good father. His great-grandpa, Marius.